territorial demons, arguments exist side by side in Christians. We're going to look at it. You see, when we got saved from our sinful nature. But that doesn't mean that there are things in our lives that also got saved automatically. Because if it was so, why are you battling with certain things? Why are you battling with lust? Why are you battling with lying if you've been delivered from it? So there's some demon activity that's taking place. I know I can speak to you this morning. You're listening to me. I can sense it. We're going to look at that. We're going to also look at the demon seek to influence by thought, imagination, and suggestions. It's a man thinker. It's a man thinker. If you ever seen this, you've heard about Zuma. I'm using it as an example. It was edited from him. If you ever seen when you just heard of the news that this is what Zuma did, the thought. And yeah, what did you do? You form a picture. You saw the shower and you saw the naked woman. Did you form the picture? Yes. Thoughts, imaginations, suggestions. Demons cause physical change in your body, how sickness and diseases are inflicted on you. We're also going to identify them. We're also going to look at how persistent they are. If they were persistent with Jesus, left him, said, if you are the Son of God, bow before me and I'll give you all these things. And then he left him and he said, well, Jesus was hungry at that time. Him and then this bread, stones into bread. He was persistent. 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 We're going to look at that. We're also going to look at how they operate and destroy churches. And then we're also going to look at deliverance from demons. Amen. Are you with me, beloved? Right. Turn with me to the book of Ezekiel chapter 28. I'm laying a foundation in order for me to speak to you about this topic and this subject. I need you to understand one thing, that where all these things came from. Ezekiel chapter 28. I'm so glad I'm the pastor of this church and you're not. To find Ezekiel chapter 28, my Bible is 1104. Ezekiel chapter 28. We need to first, before we get to the demons, we need to first understand the origination of Satan. We need to understand where Satan comes from. And we also need to ask this question. Did God create or make the devil? Did God make the devil? I say no. We'll see now why. God never created the devil. Now whom did God create then if he didn't create the devil? Ezekiel chapter 28 verse 15 said, thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day that thou wast talking about Satan created till iniquity was found in you. If Ezekiel 28 verse 15 said that Satan, before he was Satan, was perfect in all his ways until the day that iniquity was found in him. If you read the whole chapter of Ezekiel chapter 28, you will find out that when Satan was created, he was created for God. It is suggested that he was the chief angel leading worship in heaven. It is also said that he was created beautiful. Let me read it for you. It says, Ezekiel chapter 28 from verse 11 says, moreover, the word of the Lord came to me saying, son of man, take up lamentation for the king of Tyre and say to him, thus says the Lord, your God, you were the seal of perfection. The prince of Tyre here is referred to Satan himself. It's referred to Lucifer. It says you are the seal of perfection, full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. perfection. In other words, when he was created, he was perfect in everything. So God never created Satan because Satan is not perfect now. The Bible says besides that he was perfect, he was also full of wisdom. He was beautiful. Isaiah talks about when we see Satan, we will say, is this the man that has deceived us for all these years? Because his beauty, his wisdom, that is what God has created. Then the Bible said in verse 13, you are in Eden, the garden of God. He was there. We're going to look at that in Genesis chapter 1 later on. Every precious stone was your covering. You were covered with the things that people go underground now to dig for, get out, lose their lives. People are trading with these things. The jasper, the pearl, the ruby, the diamond, and then all these precious stones. You were covered with them, Satan. You had them all before you became Satan. I covered you with that. You were beautified. You were beautiful. When people look at you and they behold you, they admire you because that is what I have created. God never created junk. God never created anything that was bad. That happened because people turned their backs against God. Right, let's carry on. He talks about the beryl, the onyx, the jasper, the sapphire, turquoise, and emerald with gold. The workmanship of your timbrels and pipes was prepared for you on the day you were created. In other words, everything, the whole orchestra was in you, Satan. That's why the biggest deception now that Satan has from the young people and on many other people is through music. It's through listening to this music. Listen to the lyrics, not just the beats. Listen to the person that write these things and the person that sing these things. Look at their lifestyles. So that was deception because you see, Satan cannot create anything. He can just pervert it. He's not a creator. He perverts what God has done. He takes the beauty of what God has done and he makes it ugly. Now God has never created him. This is what God has created in Ezekiel chapter 28. Something that was beautiful. And Ezekiel said that you had everything in you. You had all the pipes and all the organs. You were orchestra all by yourself. That's how you find out in churches. If there's a problem, the problem starts with the worship team. But it starts with music. It starts with people becoming puffed up. And I thank God we don't have it in this church. They become puffed up because now I can play. Now I can sing. And now I go and I have a gig. And I go and play at the club. And I come Sunday morning and I play in the church. And the same anointing must come there. No, Satan wants you to take that which God has given you to pervert it. Because he cannot create anything. And he's so after you because you've been created in the image and likeness of God. And he will show you things that look right but they are not right. Amen. He's a master in deception. He's a master in disguise. That's why we need to expose this thing that you know what is from God and what is not from God. Amen. Amen. We saw last week Sunday night, those of you that missed it, you'll never have another opportunity. Last week Sunday night, what music do to people? Because he had everything in him, he wanted people to worship him now. He was created with these things.